If you can't start your day without reaching for a cup of coffee, you're not alone. The National Coffee Association found 62% of Americans have at least a daily cup, and it's a trend that's been consistently on the rise. We're also starting to favor our gourmet coffees and our espressos, but the U.S. is far from the top of the list as far as per capita coffee consumption. While Americans tend to average around 9 pounds a year, people in Finland just laugh at that adorably low number.
Some people drink coffee that late.
Yeah, people who work at NORAD who are on 24-hour missile watch.
They put away an average of 26 pounds of coffee per person, and they drink it all day long. It's a way of life, and that brings up a very important question. What really happens to your body when you drink it? Hardcore workouts. If you dread going to the gym, try drinking some coffee before you go work out. It sounds strange at first, but there's a few things at work here. Let's start with studies that have shown coffee helps improve the quality of your breathing. We've known this for a long time, and Harvard University studies dating back to 1993 found that caffeine helps the tissues of the lungs relax, and in turn, that makes it easier to breathe. That's true even of asthma sufferers, and though a cup of coffee isn't going to replace an inhaler, it certainly seems to help reduce symptoms. It's obvious how that's going to help you get the most out of your workout, but that's not the only thing coffee brings to the table. According to Dr. Caroline Apovian, director of the Nutrition and Weight Management Center at the Boston Medical Center, consuming caffeine just before a workout has a few surprising benefits. It temporarily increases your endurance, leading to a higher intensity workout than you would experience otherwise, and also increases dopamine levels. The last part is huge. An increase of dopamine means you're going to feel less pain and more pleasure. And since that's going to make your workout feel more enjoyable, it'll help get you off the couch and exercising more often. Coffee is practically motivation in a cup.
This drink, I like it.
I know, it's great, right?
Another!
Boosting long-term memory. Pretty much everyone can use a boost when it comes to the memory department, and here's where coffee comes in. In 2014, researchers at Johns Hopkins University staged an experiment to find out whether or not coffee has any impact on your long-term memory.
I want in.
It does. They asked volunteers to study a group of images, then gave them either a dose of caffeine or a placebo. Those who actually had the caffeine did better recognizing which images they had seen before, suggesting the presence of caffeine helps the brain form clear, long-lasting mental images. The precise mechanisms aren't known yet, but it does seem to suggest that if you're in the middle of a task that hinges on memorization, you should absolutely grab some coffee. It certainly won't hurt. Pregnancy woes. You may have heard that too much coffee impacts your chances of getting pregnant, and that's no myth. One study from the University of Nevada sought to find out why women who drink more coffee seem to have a harder time getting pregnant, and they found out that caffeine interacts with the cells that form the walls of the fallopian tubes. Drink too much, and the impact is so great it can actually keep eggs from reaching the womb. Coffee might have other effects on anyone who's trying to start a family too. According to a study done by researchers from the National Institutes of Health, caffeine consumption is linked to an increased risk of miscarriage. They stress the study doesn't really say why the causality is there, but did find if either the mother or father drank more than 3 caffeinated drinks a day, it increased the chances of a miscarriage by more than 70%. What's going on here? They're not sure, but it's definitely food for thought. Increasing anxiety. If you've ever found yourself feeling anxious and worried without knowing exactly why you felt that way, you might want to check your coffee intake, because drinking too much may increase your anxiety levels. According to psychotherapist Dana Coretta Stein, clients who are already dealing with anxiety or trauma are more susceptible to feeling these effects of coffee. She says, "Short term, the coffee might help because the caffeine provides a quick pick-me-up and a brief increase in the level of happiness. But once that caffeine wears off, the symptoms are likely to come back even stronger."
How many cups have you had this morning?
None.
Plus?
5, but yours is better.
You have a problem.
Yes, I do.
There's a few things causing that anxious feeling, and it happens because caffeine acts as a sort of trigger for all the sensations involved in our basic fight-or-flight response. According to Neil J. Smotresk, a biologist and dean of the College of Science at the University of Texas at Arlington, caffeine has a sort of chain reaction in the body and brain. In response to the presence of caffeine, the body releases neurotransmitters that increase heart rate and blood flow, ultimately leading to a state of readiness similar to what you feel in an emergency situation. That's some extreme stuff. Bathroom breaks. If you're thinking about meeting someone at a coffee shop for that long-awaited first date, you might want to rethink that, lest you spend your time in the bathroom. Just what's going on here is tricky, so let's see what Lisa Wren, spokesperson for the Dietitians Association of Australia, has to say. There is evidence that caffeine in higher amounts acts as a diuretic in some people, but moderate intake is actually not that significant. That said, you still might want to rethink your coffee house date, because while you might not be taking lots of trips to the ladies' room, you might find yourself taking an awkwardly long one. That's because coffee has a laxative effect on 30 to 40% of the population. And while we're not sure exactly why it happens, we know how. According to the American Chemical Society's reaction series, coffee stimulates a part of the colon that's responsible for sending you on a trip to the bathroom. The good news? You might be one of the lucky ones.
Todd! Are you not aware that I get farty and bloated with a foamy latte?
Thanks for watching. Click the list icon to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Plus, check out all this cool stuff we know you'll love too.